actually very interesting, diverting third speaker because it's unique, different speech. Gonna be delivered by a very, very powerful and very person who can very easily convince you in something. And it's gonna be delivered for project number two, Advanced Communication Series Public Relations. It's gonna be extraordinary project. Why? Because it's gonna be the radio talk show. So we're gonna have a unique experience to be at the radio talk show, which is gonna be hosted by the host of this program, gonna be Andy. So he's gonna help. But remember, the speaker will be, I will just announce who will be. It's gonna be between 3 and 5 minutes, the speech. So the objective will be to present a positive image of the show and just to show how positively basically you can convince people or business to talk. Later on, there'll be prepared questions, so be ready. If you want to ask a question as an open air, you know how is radio. So just raise your hand if you'll be ready to ask or answer the questions. We'll be between 2 and 3 minutes given for the questions. So I invite to the stage Roy to show us the radio talk show.
Okay, welcome back. We're back here at Talk 104 FM. I'm your host, Andy Highton, and we've just had walking into our studio Roy Kaufman, who is the author of a new book, New World Revolution, The Awakening. Roy, I've had a look at this book, and I've got a few questions for you. Why did you choose the title for this book?
Well, as we're all aware, in the world there's a lot of corruption. There's a lot of terrible things happening with corporations and everything. And there's always been a revolution to make change. And New World Revolution is what needs to be done. And the awakening is to wake people up, because there's a lot of people who are asleep.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And I see from a lot of your personal stories that you are exposing a lot of industries in this book. Are you afraid of what could happen to you over this?
I've been told by a few people that I could get whacked, basically, because of this. I have delayed the launch of the book because my daughter was doing her exams, and my mother begged me not to do it because she's convinced there'll be a lot of press when it does hit the shelves. So I'm not afraid because I've got a lot of people backing me. It's going to go out in mass production. I'm going to self-publish it so that there won't be media controlling what's happening.
Okay, maybe for those listeners of ours who are not aware of the book, can you just, like, maybe in two sentences tell us what the book is about?
Okay, it's a synopsis broken down into little pieces of what I believe are the most important things happening in the world at the moment, including war, prison systems, food. So it's about health, wealth, and finances, including the banking system as well. The reason I've kept it small is there's fantastic books out there that give amazing information on every single topic I've covered, but the problem is people aren't reading these books, or if they do, they're doing nothing about it. So my target is to reach the masses by actually getting out there and making it simple to read, so you can just open a certain chapter and it gives you solutions as well. I'm not just complaining, I'm actually giving solutions how we're going to make change.
Okay, well, because I can see that with some of the advice that you mentioned here, we can seriously reduce cancer in society. Would you like to tell us on some of the ways that we can do this?
How I actually got about that is I read a book on rats, and people that lived the longest were in the Himalayas. They were living to over 100 years. And obviously people living there didn't have access to the medical industry that we have now. and a doctor studied what they were eating, and he then tested rats which had the same organs as humans. So a rat of 2 years lives equivalent of 50 years of a human. So what they'd done is they fed the same food to the rats, and they had no illnesses, no tumors, no cancers, no reproductive problems or anything. And then they fed them cheap food, which basically cheap food of the Indians, and what happened is they got cancers, tumors and everything. So that was proving what how rats relate to us. And now we have, say, aspartame is in a lot of products like chewing gum, Diet Coke, and people think, oh, it's great, it's not sugar, but it was actually banned. That product was banned, and those senators were bribed to allow it to be passed, and it's been proved, they're saying it's safe, but yet it causes cancer in rats. So that alone, for me, tells me we should not have aspartame in our system.
Okay, well, maybe one more question, and then we're going to go to our listening audience. As we're based in Woot, you mentioned a lot about court cases and corruption in our city. Do you really think that you can make a difference?
I do. I believe I can make a difference because what I'm trying to do is gather momentum. I've already created a website, so I want people to join, you know, get in. We're in the process of forming a foundation, so all the profits from the book is going directly into the foundation, which will basically be educating people. I'll give you an example of how the system can be changed. During my process of working with a lot of companies and a lot of investors, we came across bailiffs when those companies going into bankruptcy. And basically, we found that most of the bailiffs were actually corrupt. In one case, we had I had people that were actually at the meeting of the bailiff auction, and they bribed everybody in the room, so they bought it themselves. And these kind of things are happening without people knowing, and I'm exposing them all.
Wow, fascinating. Right, so I know that there's thousands of people listening to our show at the moment. Let's pretend that they're telephoning, and if they lift their hands, we can pretend that they're telephoning us. So, who do we have on line one? Oh, okay, it's Bogdan from Romania. He's listening on the internet. Bogdan, what's your question?
Hello, Roy. Thank you. Where can I buy it?
Hi, Bogdan. Yes, basically, Amazon, Barnes & Noble, or booking, bookdepository.com. And there's PDF forms available as well. So if you go into newworldrevolution.com, you will find all the details.
Do you have a sign-off schedule? Like,
can you repeat that question?
can you give some autographs of the books?
Of course. I'd be delighted to.
Okay, thank you, Bogdan. and we have another caller. Who's our other caller? Oh, okay, it's Radek from Dell. Yes, Radek.
Hello, Roy. I'm delighted to talk to you all today. And actually, my question is the same as for my friends. Do you believe in your success through this book?
It's not about success for me. It's not about publicity for me. It's about making change in the world. My grandmother used to tell me that her father, they were saying, oh, the world is terrible. And his answer was, the world is beautiful. It's the people that make it terrible. So my aim is to actually change the viewpoints of people to make beautiful living.
Great answer. People told me that you're a great man.
Okay. Keep that thought with you, Radek. Okay, and I think we've got time for one more caller. Yes, it's Anastasia, all the way from Ukraine. Yes, Anastasia, go ahead.
Hello, Roy. I'm really pleased, actually, to talk to you now. And regarding your book, I was wondering, you're talking a lot about changing the world and how, actually, your book is actually intention to change world. But did you start from changing the world starting from yourself? Did you start with any examples doing it? Can you share with us?
Yes, basically most of this is my life experience. It's like, it's not in the book, but personally, like I've got a relationship that I've got a child and we had a divorce. And in the court, the judge basically said that she's never witnessed such an amicable situation where people are so good. So for me, teaching my child to love and respect his mother is actually me giving an example of everything, because if my child can be perfect grown up, it means the world has a better chance. And I do that with all my children, and I think if everybody could do the same, it's where we start at youth.
Very nice. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Anastasia. And I think we have time for one more caller. Do we? No, I can hear my producer. Ooh, okay, yes, Gerardo. Is that Gerardo all the way from Mexico giving us a call there?
Yes, right. In this case, I mean, what is the situation that you have faced? Because normally corruption involves a lot of
no swearing, please, girl.
I forgot the question.
Okay, Gerardo, you call us every week like that, don't you? Okay, I'm sorry. Then we've had Roy Kaufman here today. Thank you very much. We're completely out of time.